Hey everyone, and welcome to the start of a new weekly reading vlog. It is now Wednesday and I've just finished filming two main videos. And I'm very pleased with that because I haven't been feeling the most productive and motivated when it comes to filming videos, but today it went well, so yay for that. And also I've been doing some work for my master's degree. I had to read some articles and I also have to finish an assignment later this afternoon, so overall I have enough to do to keep me busy right now. But luckily I can also still find some time to read because my reading mood has been definitely great for the last week. And the book that I'm actually still reading right now is one that I've been reading for a couple of weeks, and that is The Radium Girls by Kate Moore. Talked about it before, but it's nonfiction about the girls who worked in radium factories in the 1920s and got very sick from that, and the lawsuit that they filed against the companies, and the companies who said that radium definitely is not dangerous, which is questionable to say the least. It is very well written and I'm still really enjoying the writing style because it's so approachable and just so easy to get into. It tells a very serious and very tragic and horrible story in such a easy way, which is, it sounds weird like that, but if you read the book it makes sense. Like, there are definitely some things in there that are just wow. A lot of things, basically. And some of the details about how the girls get sick and what is happening to them are graphic, but still somehow, yeah, I don't know, I'm really enjoying it. And of course not enjoying it as in like I don't enjoy their suffering, but the way it is written is so intriguing. I'm just slowly making my way through this. I've read a couple of other books in the meantime and just like reading this on and off, and I'm perfectly happy with that right now. So yeah, that's pretty much what I'm doing, but I definitely want to finish it this week because I'm also very ready to read just like a new book on my TBR, because I've been like currently reading a couple of books for a long time now, and I don't know, I don't really like the feeling of having like a lot of books on my currently reading list. So I've been like sort of trying to trim it down. That's why I want to finish this one as well. And then after that I am very excited to start a new book, like maybe a completely different book, a different genre, I don't know. I have no clue what I want to read next. But yeah, hopefully I can do that this week. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that I will finish Radium Girl somewhere this week, and then I have, I don't know what I want to read next, but something different. Apart from that, this week is not going to be very eventful because of course there's not a lot you can do these days. But as I mentioned before, I have lots of things for my masters to keep me busy. I have lots of video things that I can do to keep me busy. So you know, my life just goes on. Also, I'm also preparing some things for when I move next month to my own apartment. So I don't know if I mentioned it in a video before, but I now have some furniture, or at least I've ordered it. I've ordered, like bought my own couch, and it just feels so adult. Like, I've bought my own couch. I don't know why that makes me so happy and giddy, but it does. It won't be delivered until Christmas, so I probably have to find something for like in the meantime because I move halfway through November, but still. It just makes me so happy. Like, I'm an adult. I buy my own couch for my own home. And also I'm taking over some furniture from the current owners, the people that are currently living there, because they still had some very good things that I cannot really take with them to their place. So yeah, that is really nice that I could get some things for a very nice price, you know, not too expensive. So overall, I actually already have quite a bit of stuff, at least when it comes to furniture. I don't have that much of like other things, like pans and utensils and things like that. That is definitely still on my to-do list because of course that's also needed, and I still need a bed. I need to pick out a bed. I have a couple of options, but it's probably wise to order those or like that in somewhere in the next couple of weeks as well. So yeah, as it turns out, moving from like my childhood home is definitely going to take some work. I've also started yeah, basically going through my closet and organizing all my clothes. And I'm looking over there because you cannot see it, but there's a giant pile of clothes, and there's also a sack of clothes of things that are going away. So like, I put all the mess in that side of the room so you cannot see it. I'm trying to go through my closet bit by bit so it's not like too much in a single day, so I can also do other things. But basically this whole moving thing has already made me realize I have a lot of stuff. Probably too much stuff. And there were so many clothes that I found in the back of my closet that I don't fit anymore, that I don't wear anymore. So those are going away. Maybe there are some things that I can sell. The rest I will just donate. I also need to move all my books. That is going to be interesting probably. So probably need to unhaul some books as well, or at least organize them. See if there's something that I can give away, donate, whatever, sell. See if I can find another home. There's just basically a lot that needs to happen. But I also like it because it's the perfect excuse to sort of clean up my room and clean up all my stuff and have like a fresh start in my new place, so yeah. And also because people have been asking if I'm going to do moving vlogs, I'm definitely planning to do that because not only do I think it's fun to show you guys, I also think that it's fun for me to look back to. Like when I'm older and then I see the moving vlogs of me moving to my own apartment for the very first time. That's just going to be fun. So I'm planning to do that, so don't worry, you are going to see it. And yeah, I'm very excited for it. I will keep you updated. It is also going to be, well, not the first time that I'm moving house, because we moved into this house when I was 4 years old. But when you're 4 years old, it's not, I don't know, it wasn't that big of a deal, at least not to me. When you're four, you just take life as it comes. And now that I'm an adult, it's just different somehow. And also I moved like with my family and now I'm going to live on my own. So it is quite different. But I'm very excited to be living in the city and yeah, just have a different perspective, a different kind of, yeah, way of living, I guess. And I feel like I'm just rambling on right now. That's probably not what you're here for. Apologies, but yeah, that's pretty much what I'm doing right now. And I do like that I have this project to focus on. And yeah, still lots and lots of cleaning up to do, organizing to do. So that's also something that definitely keeps me busy this week. But now I really need to get back to my assignment because it has to be handed in tonight. So let's just do that first. Hey, it is now Thursday, it's the next day. I have finished my assignment of yesterday, I've handed it in. And now today I'm working on a completely different assignment because basically, this master's degree so far has been a string of assignments, just on and on and on. I have to hand in like 3 or 4 assignments every week, and none of them are very big, but it's just not what I'm used to, I guess, because with history, that was definitely not the case. It's just more reading and like big research, and here you have to do lots of smaller things, at least so far. I don't know how the second term and the rest of the year is going to be, but it's definitely something different and it feels a bit high school-ish because you do have like homework, things you have to finish on a weekly basis. But luckily the stuff is very interesting, so at least I have that going. Also, I haven't continued with organizing my clothes in my closet, so my room is still a mess on the other side of the camera. I really need to continue with that, but it's just, there are so many tiny things that need to be done, or like not even tiny, but just so many chores somehow, and I usually don't really feel like doing them all that much. And I don't know, yesterday I was really productive, today I feel a bit more But luckily I also have something fun today, because in a little while I'm going over to Brit's house, Brit's apartment, from basically Brit, in case you don't know her. But if you have been following me on my channel, you probably know her because I have mentioned her before. But yeah, I'm going over to her apartment and we're going to order in some food and yeah, just have a nice evening and relaxing and chatting, because it has been a while since I've seen her, so that should be a lot of fun. And I'm also going to get some of her new shop items, because Brit has her own web shop with lots of like amazing bookmarks and other things, and she has some new things, I believe also some Christmas things already. So I definitely need to do some shopping, but luckily I can do it in person at Brit's apartment, so I'm going to do that. And I'm very much looking forward to that. So that is going to be a lot of fun. And yeah, right now I should probably go back to some schoolwork, and then I do have something very nice to look forward to. Sunday, and I didn't film anything for the past 2 days, so I think it's time to get you back up to date, you know, what I've been doing. So as I mentioned before, I visited Brit at her apartment and we had a really nice night just relaxing, ordering some food. We had like burgers and fries and it was really good. And also, as I think I mentioned before, she launched some new items for her webshop, so of course I had to buy them, because you know, I need to have all her items because they are amazing. So the first new item is this bookmark, and it's actually not completely new because she already has this in a golden color, but she decided to make it in a silver color as well, and it says Stay Wild Moonchild, and it's very pretty. Then she also got a new Christmas bookmark, because of course, well, it is still October, but Christmas is slowly approaching. And you can never have enough Christmas items, and you can never be too early with buying Christmas items, so I got this gorgeous Christmas bookmark that is just amazing, and I always love Brits bookmarks because they're of such a nice sturdy material and I love to use them. And then I also got, well, not really a new bookmark, but I sort of she is doing something different with this one. So that is this one, and she has put a little tassel on it for me because she's now also selling this bookmark but with a tassel. I don't think she has a lot of them. I think they're quite limited, but with me she just put it on the one that I already have. I have it like in my book right now, so I love it. I love those kinds of tassels because if you put them in your book, I love the way it looks. It looks so nice and cute. So you can buy those at her web shop, and again, these are limited, but they're very pretty. Oh, whoa, wait. One more item that I got that I almost forgot, that is a new tote bag, because she already had one tote bag, but she added another to her collection of like the web shop, and that is this one. It says proud book nerd, which of course I am, and also I love using tote bags because they are so useful. I use them all the time for groceries, for shopping, for whatever. And I had to have this one as well because I love them so much, and you can never have enough in my opinion. So yeah. Those are the new, basically Brit items that I got. And then apart from that, the past couple of days, I haven't done much. Just the usual school things and a bit of more organizing. I did some more organizing with my clothes because lots is going away, as I mentioned before. This project, cleaning out my room, is going to take ages, I think. But yeah, I do like to have things organized, but just the process isn't my favorite. And also I want to order some new clothes because I have a discount code, and also all the new autumn collections are available, and I love autumn colored sweaters. Do I need more? Probably not, but I want more as always. And yeah, so it's sort of like I'm getting rid of clothes and then I'm getting new clothes. I just really want a wardrobe upgrade, even though I probably shouldn't get too much. Yeah, also, yeah, basically for reading, it hasn't been great. I haven't read that much of The Radiant Girls since I last spoke to you. I don't know, somehow I haven't really felt like it this week. I really hope I'm not heading for another reading slump. I don't think so. I just think that maybe I need another book to read as well, because I like this book in bits, just reading bits of it. So I guess I just have to sort of figure out my reading mood and see how that goes. And yeah, I do still like it. It's not that it's a bad book, but I feel because I sort of already know how this, yeah, particular piece of history ended, you know what's going to happen, even though it's, you know, it's true life. There isn't much tension because I know it, sort of. So I'm not like, oh my god, what's going to happen next, because I already know that. And yeah, it's hard to explain. That's maybe the thing with nonfiction books somehow. Still love it, but yeah, I still need to finish it. So probably not in this reading vlog, but who knows, maybe tonight I feel like reading, I don't know. That is again something that, yeah, I just need to be in the look at the tassel, by the way. That's fun. But again, that's something that I need to be in the mood for, so who knows. Something else, by the way, that I've done this week that is just so, so fun is that I got an old VHS tape. Videotape of like childhood videos. I got it digitized, so I now have it on my laptop and I've been watching that, and it's just so cute. It's from the year 2002. It's the first year of my sister's life, like after she was born, so it includes all the family videos of that year. And sorry, I can't show it to you because almost everything includes my brother and sister as well, and I don't think they want their childhood videos on the internet, but just trust me. It is so cute. Like my sister as a baby and me holding my sister for the very first time is so sweet, but also other things like birthdays and Christmas of that year and her summer holiday, and just it's so cute because in this time period I am 6 years old, my brother is 3 years old, and my sister is 0, she's a baby. And it's so weird to look at yourself from so long ago because I remember some of those things. Other things I don't remember, but there are definitely things that I very clearly remember. But at the same time, it doesn't feel like me if I'm watching it. It somehow feels like a completely different person, even though I know it's me and I recognize me and I remember it. But it feels so weird, like from a different world. But it's the cutest thing ever. And now we're getting like all of our home videos digitalized. That didn't go very well, but anyway, we're going to get all of our old video tapes, like VHS tapes, digitized, because you know it's nice to see them again and to save them. So if I ever have like a cute piece that is just me that I can share, then I will share it. But yeah, I can't really share like other people's childhood videos, even though it's my brother and sister, but they don't want to be, I don't think they want their baby things on my YouTube channel. But anyway, if I find cute things in the future that is just me, then I will share it. So just trust me, it's very cute. It's just so fun to see myself. Like, I haven't watched old videos of myself as like an actual kid in ages. So a bit random, but that was so much fun. Like, I'm still just smiling thinking about it. It's so cute. Like, we're so cute and so tiny. And yeah, anyway, I think that's pretty much it for like what I had to update you guys on. And yeah, now it's almost time for dinner, and I think I'm just going to do some more school things and who knows, maybe read a little bit if I'm going really crazy. And yeah, just a normal Sunday evening, I guess. So I forgot to end the reading vlog, so let me just do that now real quickly. In any case, I did read a bit more of The Radium Girls, not that much, but a bit more. And I feel like I'm getting the reading groove a little bit back, maybe, I don't know. That story should be continued in another reading vlog, but anyway, I still really do love the book. It's just so beautifully written. I really, really appreciate it when a book is so well written, and this one is just very, very well done. And again, I did not finish it this week, but still, I read a little bit of it, so that's still better than nothing. But this is it then for this reading vlog, and I really do hope that you liked it. If you did, maybe go subscribe or give it a thumbs up or share or whatever. As always, I would really appreciate that. And hopefully, I will see you again very soon in my next video. Bye!